The next question I have received, the brother has a question. Reciting Fatiha for her dad is being done in Eastern countries. Let me make it very simple. This kind of ritual and custom has been going on in several countries, like in Eastern South Asia, in several other countries also, where somebody died, people recite Fatiha, and it's called Khatam-e-Quran or Quran Khani, and they do that after 40 days and the annual anniversary. So let me make it simple. The Prophet didn't do that, the Sahaba didn't do that, the four ulama didn't do that. So I'm going to ask a counter question to you. Why do you do that? If you are the one who's doing that, I'm going to be asking you a question. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you don't find any kind of ahadith where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if anybody died, they recited Surat Fatiha. And also, we do not find any kind of source where any Sahaba did that. There's thousands of Sahaba who's being died in the battlefields and with the disease and with other causes. And so let's make it simple. If the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't do that, if the Sahaba didn't do that, if the four great scholars of Islam, may peace be and blessing be upon him, didn't do that, then why I do that? Let's say, for an example, I'm doing that. I'm going to ask my question. Whose way I'm following? Am I following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Am I following the Sahaba? Am I following the four scholars? So who did that? No one knows that, because this monopoly was being started later on, after several years later. Who started? Nobody knows exactly. But basically, everything, all these bid'ah are mostly being started from India, basically most of them. And the other countries that is being started from, and it's like Turkey, Bosnia, and Africa, and some Arab countries. So what is the reason people do that? It's people doing that because whatever their scholars, their imams, and the local imam of the masjid told them to do, and the local muftis, local scholars, or whatever, to tell them, people are doing that. So the people are failed to realize that they have to ask, in the matters of a deen, they have to ask their imam, and they have to ask the local muftis, and they have to ask their councils, like the particular ritual or the particular ibadah that we are doing, is this some way is being proven from authentic ahadith or authentic sources of the Sahaba or the great four scholars? Nowhere. So why are you doing that? So this is called something a bid'ah. This is, you fall into the category of bid'ah. Because according to the Prophet ﷺ, say every bid'ah is a misguidance, and every misguidance is going to lead to hellfire. Because what's going to happen? The current generation is going to do a Fatiha. The next generation is going to start with Surat Ikhlas. I'm giving an example. For the next generation, they're going to start something else. The next generation, they're going to start something else. So let's, in order for us to make a changing and changing and changing and changing, the whole entire thing is going to be changed. Because Allah said in the Quran, in Surah Maida, verse number 3, A'udhubillahi minash-shaytanir-rajim, Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, Al-yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum islama dina. So today I have perfected your deen. That's it. This is the period. This is the period is ended. This is the bottom line. And the Prophet ﷺ has conveyed all his lifestyle and every message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not to make a shirk, how to do ibadah, how to do the things like that. So do not start something new. So people are doing that because their intention is to do a unity, do a gathering. But you don't understand. By doing all this, there's a backstab of shaitan who is trying to backstab into the authentic teachings of the Prophet ﷺ. So in order to keep the really go back to our original sources, that is the Quran and that's the Sahih Hadith, and stick to that, and do not divide yourself to anyone with the ulama's teaching, what is the imam teaching. It is bad. It is recommended to get your opinion From Emni scholars, the Imams, Muftis, whoever you want to do, take your opinion. And I'm going to strongly encourage the students of knowledge and the general public to do your own investigation and try to differentiate between Sahih. So if anyone comes to me for a question, for a counseling or anything, after giving my answer, I do tell them, please, this is my opinion. And because since it's not in the Quran, it's not a hadith, so this is my opinion. And I also encourage you to get an opinion from other scholars. And I also, whatever the answer I'm giving you, I want you to go investigate on your own self, do your own research, and try to find the authentic hadith about that. And then you make your own judgment. Do not just follow me, or do not follow any mufti, do not follow any scholar, do not follow any maulana or scholar or anyone. Do your own research and get opinions from different scholars, but make your own judgment.